Welcome to our YouTube Learning for Knowledge channel. In this video, we will discuss another important aspect of the filtration, which is used in the cooling tower systems. That is the side stream filtration setup, its purposes, why we install this, what are the advantages, and what are different options available for side stream filtration. So we will just move towards the video. As you know, during the operation of cooling tower, the cooling water absorbs airborne particulate from the surrounding air which are present in the environment. And with the passage of time, that is with the passage of operation, these fine particles can build up and settle within the system. Due to presence of these fine particles, these basically affect the cooling tower performance and its operation. So to overcome this problem, we need another filtration system, which is also known as or called side stream filtration, and it is used in cooling water systems to reduce, number one, the suspended solids present in this water and the debris, these things which are come from outside of the tower. Now, when we apply this side stream filtration, this side stream filtration leads to control in the fouling in the system, biological growth in the tower, and corrosion in this system. This is a typical diagram which explains the installation of side stream filtration. Now, this is a cooling tower and the hot water or warm water is coming from the system, and then after coming from this, after entering into this tower, it loses, or it, you can say it dissipates the heat, and then it cool down and then it go back again into the system. Now, you can see that we will take a portion of this water which is present in the sump or in the cooling tower, and we will take this water into the side stream filtration system which we will install here, and after filtration this water will go back to the cooling tower sump or its system. Now, you can see that instead of filtering all the quantity of water, we will only take a part of the water and then we filtrate it, and after cleaning we will return this water back into the system. So this is basically, this side stream filtration phenomena is only applied by using some little amount, or you can say portion of the water present in the cooling tower system. Now, side stream filtration removes suspended particles present in the water, organics developed in the system, and silt particles. These type of impurities can be easily removed by the application of side stream filtration. There are different or various advantages or benefits of the side stream filtration. So, number one is reduction in the water consumption. Now, with the application of side stream filtration, the water consumption is reduced, because if more water is dirty, then we will have to blow down or remove this water and add fresh water into the system. So if this filtration system is installed, then because we are cleaning some part of the water, so we have opportunity to use or utilize more water in the system, and instead of adding more fresh water. Secondly, reduction in energy consumption, because when we are applying this side stream filtration, then energy consumption, because it affects the process, and the more energy is required to bring down the temperature of the system, and also the energy used in the addition of makeup water. So all these things involve, and we can save energy by the installation of side stream filtration. Reduction in chemical use. The chemical use to control the biological growth or scaling, corrosion. So if no water is lost, that is, we will not remove the water, and we can operate the system on more cycles of concentration, then definitely the chemical which are added in the system retain in the water, and more utilization of that chemicals takes place. Another good advantage is lower maintenance cost, because when dirt or other biological particles are present in the system, they will settle somewhere in these pockets in the system, piping and other areas, and that will increase in the maintenance cost. Then improvement in productivity and reduction in downtime. Of course, when more clean water is circulating in the system, then its productivity will be enhanced, and reduction in the downtime for cleaning purposes is also reduced. And then control of biological growth, it will also control the biological growth in the cooling tower system. So application of side stream filtration, that is where we need to apply this system. What type of water, what type of cooling tower, or what type of makeup water which required side stream filtration. So number one, systems that are susceptible to fouling due to the nature of application or the environment in which they operate. That is, the environment means that if there is a more dusty environment, then more fouling, more particles are present in the air, and dust storm take more dirt inside the cooling tower, and more chances of fouling. So we required, in those areas, we required side stream filtration. Now, biological problems. Even with the presence of a good biocide program. Now, biological depositions, or the when we apply some chemical, it will biocide, then it will kill the biological growth, algae and other things. Now, these things are still present in the water and circulate. So, side stream filtration help to remove these dead particles of the biological species. And primary source of water is a surface or other an unclarified, example river or stream, that is the water which will take from rivers, stream or open surface, then that require also side stream filtration. High levels of solids build up in the sump due to dirt and debris, that I already explained this, that lot of dirt and debris settle down or deposit present in the sump due to windy conditions and due to dust storms. And heat exchange, wherever heat exchange requires frequent mechanical cleaning, it means there are more dirt are present which is settled down in the heat exchanger tubes and heat exchanger areas. So we need to reduce the dirt and other suspended particles. That's why this side stream filtration is required to be applied. Now in here I am just summarizing only few options with reference to their sizes available in the side stream filtration system. If there are different types depending upon their size and their requirement, for example, we need centrifugal separators. This has size of 40 to 75 microns, and other sand filters, they have nominal 10 micron size. Automatic screen filters, they were down to 10 microns. Microfiltration have a size of around 0.1 microns, and high efficiency media filters down to 0.45 micron. The detail of these different type of side stream filtration may be discussed in the coming videos which will be present in the future. So you can get more information on the system, and we will try to provide you information regarding water treatment and other aspects of water usages. So hopefully you will like our video and you will keep watching our channel. Thank you very much.